Well, hello everybody, and welcome to Daily's Place. We're back at it again, and man, going off the words we heard from the competitors that will be competing in this match, I wonder who will stand tall. Will it be the bright and new and blue sky blue? Or will it be Mommy in Rhea Ripley? Rhea Ripley. She's always on top, but Sky Blue is a new competitor. We haven't seen much of her. I have only seen her compete in dark matches, but she is here to prove something. Will Sky Blue be able to, or will she not? And if you notice, along the bottom of your screen, we see the matches that are also taking place here tonight. And man, oh man, are we lined up, because next up after this, we have Jon Moxley in action. And he has some words for Roman Reigns regarding their match stipulation at Castle Clash. And then for our third match of the night, we will be seeing the Dusty Cup Finals between Better Than You Bebe and Ridge Dragon. And for our main event, we'll be seeing Cody Rhodes in action against a very hungry Pete Dunne. Want to talk about a match I want to see, ladies and gentlemen, that is definitely one of them. Cody Rhodes versus Pete Dunne. Holy shit. But besides all that, ladies and gentlemen, let's focus on the match that's opening up the show. Rhea Ripley versus Sky Blue. Rhea Ripley is going to have to take some mental notes with this new challenger in front of her here tonight in Sky Blue. Because Sky Blue told me on the way up here that she sees herself as a rebirth Undisputed Women's Champion. And I asked her, that's good, you have high hopes for yourself. But will you be able to take on the best, take on the ruthless Mommy, if given the chance? And she said, I'm up for anything. So, will Sky Blue stand tall against her first encounter against Rhea Ripley? Or will the newcomer only get what's coming to her? We will be seeing here in Daily's Place. And the ref for this match is Petra Pinfall. Oh, God. Nice dodge by Sky Blue. Sky Blue. Oh, hip toss. God damn, Sky Blue already noting. Oh, powerbomb by Rhea Ripley. Pinfall. One, two. Oh, kick out. Sky Blue already dodging one of Rhea's, known moves, the running big boot. That's smart on her, but she needs to keep a track of Ripley's ability to reverse, because she caught her with that powerbomb. Oh, Sky Blue. Oh, attack and a tricep. Going for the pinfall again. But I think Sky Blue is going to have to do way more than just that. Oh, cradle. One, two. Oh, she almost caught Rhea off guard with that. Ooh, that was almost horrible. Sky Blue running in security. Rhea just able to get right back up. Oh, slap and a clubbing blow to the back. Oh, where are we going? Into the corner. Oh, drop kick. Oh, God. Right to the tits. Oh, now shoving her foot in the throat. Sky Blue taking some time. It went, oh, whoa, oh, into a Black Widow. Oh, man. Could this be it for Rhea Ripley? Oh, Sky Blue has got locked in. She watched a lot of AJ Lee videos, you know, growing up. You know, AJ Lee is one of her favorite wrestlers, you know, back from her childhood. But I think Rhea Ripley will be able to crush a Black Widow. Oh, yep. Yep. Oh, side slam. Rhea tossing out Sky Blue onto the apron. Oh, 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 hot shot. Oh, Sky Blue don't even know where she is at. Oh, but she gets thrown into the barricade viciously by Rhea Ripley. Oh, oh. Oh, back and forth. Oh, God. Oh, oh no. Where are we going with this? Oh, oh, Sky Blue catching her at the top. Oh my God. Oh, big boot though catches her. Oh, Rhea. Oh, no electric. Oh, oh, Sky Blue. Oh man, showing Rhea Ripley. She is ready for the Sky Blue, not hot on the go for getting the advantage. Rhea kind of dumbfounded, trying to find out where she is. Oh, big boot dodged by Sky Blue. Oh, 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 going for the pinfall after that takedown. One, two. Oh, kick out from Rhea Ripley. Sky going up. Sky Blue up. Oh, nobody there. Nobody there. What? The ring mat. Oh, oh, oh. Riptide. One, two, three. And Rhea Ripley stands tall. veteran, John Moxley. Like I said earlier, he has some words for Roman Reigns regarding their stipulation at Castle Clash. And Moxley just said, "Oh, you think you're safe up there? You think you're safe on your throne, on your high chair? Not when you're gonna face me." And he told him last week that he will be revealing the stipulation for their match this week if he won last week. And that he did. And now the question is what type of match will they be competing in at Castle Clash this coming weekend? You will be saying, but who knows, maybe Tyler Bate can catch him off guard and win some new wins for him in British Strong Style. But who knows, maybe he'll just get his shit stomped in by John Moxley. And here we go, and oh, whoa, look at that dodge by Tyler Bate. Oh, but that doesn't count on the second go around. Tyler Bate just rolling into it, dodging it. I bet he's played some Dark Souls, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, but John Moxley just showing him why you shouldn't just fuck with Moxley. You should not fuck with Moxley. Oh my God, driving the spine into the barricade. Already brutal from Moxley. Goddamn, picking him up. Oh, power bomb time. Oh no, Tyler Bate rolled him up. Sunset flip, roll up. Not pinning him, of course. Oh, I thought he was gonna bash his face off the LED board, but no. Tyler Bate ain't taking the chance. I mean, taking a chance, ain't doing it, which is weird because I thought he would, especially against John Moxley. Oh, kick to the arm. Tyler Bate keeping out of the grasp of John. What the? Oh, God. Straight down DDD suplex. Working on the shoulder. Oh, my God. Big strong point tossing John Moxley. One. Oh, kick out. John kicking out. Wolf. Into the corner. Oh, but big elbow. Meets him. John sending him out on the apron now. Oh no. Apron suplex. Oh, God damn. Oh no. On the barricade. God damn. Tossing him back in. Well, I don't think John will be able to make that distance. Will he be able to make this? Oh, yes, axe handle right to the face. Oh, going up now. Waking up, Tyler. Oh! Tyler dodged it. Oh, dropped another. God damn. Oh, Mark watched out for that dropkick. Oh, and hit him with a lariat, a discus lariat, a spinning lariat. Oh. Oh shit, John sending out Tyler Bate now. Right, he gets up right into the pile driver. And right into the death wire! Oh my God. Mox sends him in. And Tyler Bate, one, two, three. And John Moxley finishes him off. But now he's grabbing the microphone.
Here is your winner, John Moxley. Well, ladies and gentlemen, wait, I'm hearing something in the back. Oh, this is what's going on in the back, ladies and gentlemen. DIY is getting attacked by the D'Angelo family. Oh, and the Don telling Channing to get Gargano out to the ring. And he's going to. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Here's Channing. Throwing in Gargano. And Channing just telling it better than you, baby, that they owe the Don. Johnny is just out of it, ladies and gentlemen. Getting up. And Johnny gets up. Oh, Adam Cole with the last shot. Oh my God, is that gonna be it for DIY? 1, 2. Oh, Johnny Gargano kicked out. Oh, and Adam Cole picking up Johnny Gargano. Gargano is out of it. Oh, tagging in MJF. Oh, shit. No. Double clothesline. Will it be for Gargano? 1, 2. No! Kick out. Oh, my God. Oh, MJF going up. Gargano doesn't know where he's at. Oh! Gets a clubbing shot to the head. Yep, dragging him. Yep, going up again. Oh, MJF! Oh, again! Wait. He's going up for the elbow. Oh, nobody there. Oh, Gargano by Gargano. Oh, clothesline. Oh, Gargano, feeling it. Oh, Vince-a-Gary. Oh, shit, tossing him out. Oh, and Johnny, going. Oh, suicide tool. Oh, my God, suicide DDT. Oh, and catching Adam Cole with the slingshot. Oh, one final beat. Oh, catapult kick. Oh, Gargano. Oh, ducked it. Oh, MJF ducked it. Oh, to the back of the head of Gargano. Will this be it? 4, 1, 2. Oh, no, it won't. No, it won't. Oh, shit. Oh, no. Going for the... Oh, Oh god, that Heatseeker. Jeff. It's like, you want to see me do this? Fine. What is he doing? MJF. Someone is behind him. Tommaso Ciampa, drenched in blood, with a shovel to bear. And Adam Cole is out. And I bet MJF wishy woozy. Oh my god. Three shots of it. Oh, MJF catches him. Now getting ready. Oh, but Johnny Gargano is right there. Oh, man. We have not seen Adam Cole at all, ladies and gentlemen. Makes you think who will come out the winner. Oh, MJF dodging the catapult kick. But Gargano sending him in. Oh. Oh, snap, Mayor. Drop him. Oh, shit. Johnny Gargano is getting ready for the lawn dart. Oh, face full of turmoil. Gets up. Oh, pump kick from Adam Cole. But Adam Cole is not the legal member, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, my shot. Oh, no. Johnny ducked it. Oh, shit. Oh. Oh, my God. Beautiful transition. Oh, get to that. Oh, my gosh. Johnny Gargano waking himself back up. And there's Tommaso Ciampa. Oh, but getting kicked in the face by Adam Cole. Oh, Ciampa must have used a healing agent to get all his blood out of his face. I mean, or stitches. I saw him over by the doctor, so I think, yeah, he got some stitches. Goddamn. Oh, Adam Cole getting out of the Fujiwara. Oh, in to the last shot. Oh, God, right to the back of Ciampa. Will this be it for Tommaso Ciampa? Will this be it for DIY? No, kick out. Johnny Gargano battling MJF on the outside. Oh, suplex by Adam Cole. Now tossing Ciampa into DIY's corner. Nobody's there. So it doesn't help Ciampa at all. Hanging DDT. Yes, Adam Cole got playing now. Oh, he's looking away for Fujiwara. Oh, Ciampa. Oh, to lose by your own finisher would be salt in the wound, plus to be taken out before the match. But DIY has a next level of resiliency, ladies and gentlemen. Surprises me that they're still in this match. I mean, I know they can go all night, but Jesus. Brutal attack from the D'Angelo family. And, you know, I thought Johnny was going to be hell out of luck, especially with his having his skull driven into the concrete in the back by Channing of DIY. Oh, fuck me. Oh, God. Ciampa. Oh, going for meat in the middle. Oh. One, two. Oh, Adam Cole gets out. Johnny moving back. Oh, but MJF is right there. Oh, Adam Cole taking advantage. Last shot. Oh, right to the face. Oh, Ciampa breaks up the pin. Oh, right to the face. Oh, Ciampa going out for Willow's Bell to MJF. Oh, Johnny Gargano with the boots up down. Now Ciampa clearing the announce table. Johnny going for Gargano escape on the outside. Lift it up, MJF. MJF, oh, suplex off the table. Oh, Adam Cole, back up with Gargano. Oh, MJF sending him back on. Taking Ciampa. Oh, shit. MJF, oh, one buster through the table. Count of 14. Brings it. Oh, MJF throws Gargano into the... Now MJF bringing in Gargano. Just telling Adam, you do it. You finish the job. Tags in Adam Cole. Oh, yeah. Oh, from the front. And Adam goes to the pin. 1, 2. Gentlemen, we are back. The lights are on. Adam Cole trying to figure out where Gargano is. And he's going outside. Adam Cole is backstage. Oh! But gets thrown out. Whoa. Who is that? And oh my god, it's Kenny Omega! Oh, V-Trigger! V-Trigger by Omega! Oh, another one! Oh shit! Oh, powerbomb! Oh shit! Oh, dragon suplex on the concrete floor. Now, bringing in Adam Cole, sending him into the ring. Oh, and MJF taking him out with the flying elbow. MJF picking him up. Oh, shots. Oh, Kenny Omega fighting back. Oh. Oh shit! Oh, powerbomb! But followed up by the one! Oh, and yep, can have it! Oh! Oh! keeping Kenny Omega in check. Dodging the V-trigger, dodging the one-winged angel. Oh, not taking him down. With the tricep stomp. Rolling him up the ramp. And MJF turns around. Oh, Gargano's right there. Gargano, the beautiful suicide dive. Now tossing in MJF. Oh, meet in the middle. Ciampa with the pin. 1, 2, 3. And DIY will face the Bloodline at Castle Clash. On the 18th of May. And oh my God, ladies and gentlemen, who knows what will come of this? Because this is the go-home show, ladies and gentlemen. This is the match that sets up the matches, or that finishes setting up the matches that will take place at Castle Clash, and DIY pulled through, but it seems Adam Cole is not done with Kenny Omega, especially with Adam Cole now on the stage and Kenny Omega just stating his target, making his target clear for revenge for that loss at WrestleMania to finish off last series. But until then, ladies and gentlemen, congrats to DIY. Will they be able to take down the Bloodline? Will Kenny Omega be able to get his revenge on Adam Cole? We will be seeing. But until then, I think it's time we move on with the show, because we're not done yet. Ladies and gentlemen, some words from Carmelo and Cody. And here he comes. The American Nightmare. Where is he? Well, ladies and gentlemen, we still don't know where Cody Rhodes is. Wait, I'm getting reports of something happening in the back. That's Cody Rhodes. On the ground. Oh, Cody's coming too. But he doesn't look to know where he's at. Oh, it's Randy Orton. Tossing him. Where the hell are we going? Oh, and Cody getting up from that throw. And Randy RKO! And I was just telling Cody, oh, you don't know what I'm gonna do to you in the ambulance match. Because remember, folks, their match stipulation at Castle Clash is an ambulance match. Oh, Cody. Cody in the upper hand. Oh, suplex. And Cody leaving. Oh, a face full of stop sign. And look who it is. It's the Game. Triple H. Oh. On the stop sign. And Triple H leaving him be. In the arena. Oh, and ladies and gentlemen, Randy coming with Cody near the commentary desk. toss him, Cody. Getting a chair. Oh, right to the face of Cody. Randy. I'm just bringing Cody towards the ambulance. Oh, throwing him right into it. Shit. Where are we going? Oh. Oh, no. No. Oh. Oh, God, the arm. And that is Cody's injured shoulder. He injured it in a dark match against Carmelo Hayes. Oh, dropkick. Now Randy casting stupefy upon Cody, going up to the top of the ambulance. And gentlemen, we all know what happens when you cast stupefy upon your opponent. They just follow whatever you say or do. And Cody following Randy up on it. Oh, an ambulance. And Randy just saying, this is what's going to come to you. Come, Castle Clash. Cody. Oh, shit. Go. Orton. No! Powerbomb off the ambulance. And Randy. With a brutal powerbomb off the ambulance, ladies and gentlemen. And Cody looks dumbfounded. And Randy's coming down. For Randy. With one final message. Although Randy's not done. Oh! Another RKO. Randy opening the ambulance doors. Toss Cody in there. But oh, it's Dustin Rhodes. Dustin, oh, with the door to Randy. I'm not tossing Randy in. Oh, tries to catapult kick. But no, Randy catches him. Sends him face first and a low blow. Dustin now in the corner, just down and out. And Randy just using his powers to get a chair. Oh my God. Shot. It throws it in the face of Dustin Rhodes. Oh my God. And the shots with the chair. He gets up. One final chair shot to the head. Low line. Oh no. But ready? Oh, the point. As Randy stands tall over Dustin, he turns his attention towards Cody Rhodes in the ambulance. Randy going outside, just telling Cody, this is what'll happen. Nothing but collateral. And with that done, Randy Orton sends a message. Randy Orton incapacitates Cody's brother. And Randy Orton sends a message heading in to Castle Clash. But now the question is will this motivate Cody? Because Cody is now injured. Cody is now not 100%. Will he use all this as motivation towards a win over his former mentor? Or will Randy Orton hunt Cody as well to truly be the Nightmare Killer? We will be seeing. But until then, ladies and gentlemen, this has been the go-home for Castle Clash. See you all when Castle Clash hits this weekend. Or next weekend. Until then, this has been Rumor.